we have drama. So the title of this is Guitar Center Severs Ties with Behringer. For those that don't know, Behringer is Bugera amps made by Uli Behringer. And so I get this email in my inbox, and I'll give you a quote over here. Guitar Center statement. This isn't quotes, I'm reading. Decisions like this are never made easily. There are rare occasions where the integrity of the relationships and agreements we make with vendors are challenged, despite the potential impact to the bottom line or overall sales. We can't speak for anyone else in the industry, but we'd had enough of watching Behringer try to do business this way. It's not the way we like to work with people, and it's not productive. They made some questionable choices that put us into a position to develop a contingency plan. As we reevaluated that plan several weeks ago, we found that it would allow us to build better relationships with other vendor partners in the category. When Plan B starts to make this much business sense, it became clear we didn't need to tolerate this anymore. We're focused on where we can succeed in partnership with our new vendors, and we're excited about the future. So basically, well, let me read Uli Behringer's statement in response to that, and then I'll give you my opinion on what really happened. So Music Group CEO Uli Behringer says, in quotes, "We were surprised by a recent public statement issued by Guitar Center over the last year due to Guitar Center's highly publicized financial situation," which, by the way, we've been covering for a long time on thetoneking.com. Those links are below. Due to Guitar Center's highly publicized financial situation, we were forced to evaluate their credit worthiness. As a result of their credit rating, it was determined that they were a high risk. They were high risk and were forced to put them on business hold. We certainly respect Guitar Center's decision to discontinue business with us, and we thank them for our excellent 20-year relationship. So this is what I think happens, right? My opinion. So Guitar Center has some financial troubles, and when they, you know, there was a lot of talk on, you know, they owe a lot of money and they're not making the money to cover their debt. So, of course, you always have the whole, what happens if they go into bankruptcy? And if they go into bankruptcy, I think, you know, it's not like suppliers get their stuff back. You know, that kind of all goes into bankruptcy. So vendors, suppliers lose their product that they have in the store on terms. Okay. So if a store is in a bad financial situation, I, as a supplier, may not want to have real big, long, extended terms, because if something happens, I, as the supplier, will be out my product. So it looks like, you know, Behringer, the company, set, you know, scrutinizes that and maybe tries to short. So let's say you do something like a net 90, like you don't have to pay me for the next 90 days. But if there's concern, maybe you say, let's do like a net 30, right? So you don't have to pay me for 30 days. It minimizes the risk. And it sounds like that Guitar Center didn't like whatever those terms were. And perhaps they didn't like being questioned about their public financial situation. And then they sever ties and make a public statement about that, which is kind of messed up in my humble opinion. But at the end of the day, business is business. And perhaps they were making a statement, a public statement. I'm reading between the lines that perhaps they were telling other vendors, you better be careful, because if you don't play by our rules, we will dismiss you. And of course, you know, it's a catch-22. Because if you're a vendor and you make gear, perhaps, you know, and Guitar Center buys your gear, that's a lot of money that you're making, because they're a big store. But it's very risky if they are in financial trouble. So it's like, it's a gamble. It truly is a gamble. But it looks like it's their way or the highway. Otherwise, they will dismiss you. So, interesting stuff going on here. But if you want to read about the the reporting we've done on Guitar Center's financial situation. Click those links below. That is the news. That's pretty big news in my book of rules, but that's the news of the day. Oh, I was reading a blog. I'll leave you with this. So someone on Mark We in GuitarLessons.com, some other website I was Googling, trying to get other people's way in here, and someone says, the article's too long. Let me summarize this for you. And I'm quoting this guy called OGG. He says, Guitar Center will no longer carry Behringer products due to the fact that Behringer doesn't like not getting paid in full and on time according to contractual terms. Now, of course, who knows if that's true or not, but it's somebody's opinion, and I kind of sort of feel like there may be some truth to that opinion. But what the hell do I know? I'm just a guitar player. I'm not a accountant. I'm not a tax attorney or anything like that. I just find this news interesting, and I hope you do too. So let me know what you think. Leave your comments below. Leave you off one of those. Thanks for watching, as always. Until next time, rock on. Later.